Friends, myself Subhash Mishra. In the previous video, I have started the procedure. Two more things which we needed, that is plain glass light like this, and then brush. Brush is of zero group. Now I am going to take an onion. From this we will cut small pieces so that we can get a section of its fleshy scales. Now I have taken one of the fleshy leaf of onion. You can see it has two surfaces. One is the bulging surface and other is the inner surface. So from inner surface we will take thin membranous peel with the help of forceps. So I have, this is the forceps. From this I am going to take out the thin membranous peel. Students, you can see a very thin membrane. It is taken from its inner surface. This thin membrane, from this we will observe the cell. Keep this thin membranous peel on the slide, and with the help of brush put few drops of water on it. When you will put water on it, then it will help to remove the foldings from the membrane. Now cut a lenient section from it with the help of sharp blade. So you can see okay, students, now you will be you can able to see a very thin piece of membrane is there on the slide. Now on this slide we will put, we can put this thin membrane in watch glass containing little amount of water. Okay students, so I have put this section. I have put the section in it. Now I am going to put few drops of safranine coloring pigment in it. So now you can see that this liquid, it becomes colored. It becomes colored. And now I am waiting for half a minute or 1 minute so that the section can take the color, it gets stained. So after 1 minute, now wash the section with the help of brush. Actually, I don't have the brush, but you have to wash the section in the watch glass. Once the section is washed, now excess of stain is removed. Now take out carefully this section on slide. So I am going to transfer this. Okay, so students, I have put the section on it. Now we will put cover slip on it. So after putting, now I am going to put the cover slip on it. This cover slip, it should be put carefully on it. So for that, hold the this cover slip likewise diagonally and then put it on the slide with the help of needle. So I have put this cover slip on the section which I have placed on the slide. Before putting this cover slip on, we used to put few drops of glycerin. Since I don't have glycerin, that's why I have not used it. But you will put glycerin and then you will cover it. If excess of liquid is there, that is glycerin or color, then remove it with the help of filter paper. In this way, you will prepare your slide. So this is the procedure. You can write it in your own way. The next thing comes, that is observation. When you prepare the slide, you will put your slide under microscope and then you will start observing. When you will observe it, you will get compartments, small compartments are there or blocks are there. These blocks are the cells. Under the microscope, you will able to see mostly three parts, that is you will able to see its outer wall, that is cell wall, then you will able to see nucleus and cytoplasm. I'm going to show you its diagram. If you see, so diagrams are there, you will able to see blocks. These blocks are the cells. You will able to see such type of figure. Students, after that, this is the part of observation. During observation, you will write down what things you have observed, and after that it comes result. So in this experiment, what result you will get, that you have prepared the slide of you have observed the cells. And the next topic comes, that is precaution. So in this experiment, what precautions you have taken, that you will write. For example, you must have sharp blade. The onion which you are using, it should not be dry. You should not put excess of glycerin. You should not put excess of safranin. If you are putting excess of safranin and you are getting more time, it will get more stained and it will become very dark. You will unable to observe it. Students, these are the different steps which I have shown to you. So now I think you remember it very well, that when you are going to write practical in your practical record, you will first write aim of the experiment, then material required, after that procedure, after that observation. If theory or principle is there, you can write it there. Then observation, observation table if it is needed. After that, result, and then precaution. So in this way, we have finished this topic. And in next topic, we will conduct another experiment. Thanks.